It's time for the Central Iowa Real Estate Scoreboard. Right here on 1460 AM and 106.3 FM, KXNO. Now, Misty SOLDwisch and Heather Burnside.
Good morning and welcome to the Central Iowa Real Estate Scoreboard on this first Iowa State Fair Sunday. I'm Heather, she's Misty. Good morning.
Hi, Heather.
How are you?
Oh my goodness, great.
We're going to be having a team day coming up at the Iowa State Fair.
Yes.
And one reason why is because Misty and I will also be doing a show live from the Iowa State Fair at the WHO Crystal Studios today from 1 to 2 o'clock this afternoon.
I'm so excited. A lot of pressure.
Yeah. The more Misty and I talk and have gotten to know each other over the past couple of years, we realize we have so much in common.
Yes.
And one of them is our similar experiences and being participants at the Iowa State Fair as part of 4-H.
Yes.
So we're going to be talking about that and more coming up. But in the meantime, we're going to start this show by talking about what has now become an annual tradition. It's the fourth annual teacher giveaway. And Misty, this thing just seems to get bigger every year.
I absolutely love this event. We started it 4 years ago, giving away $500 in gift cards to local teachers. And this year we're giving away 70 gift cards, $3,500 worth. So the way you it's very, very easy. You nominate them on social media. We've got a post and I've got a link of how you can get to it super easily. All you do is text teacher to 35620. So, you know, you get out your phone, put in the number 35620, text teacher to it, and then you will get a link to nominate. So you just like the post, share it, nominate, tag your favorite teachers, and they will be entered to win. The drawing will be August 22nd at 4 p.m. And
that's a week from Monday.
A week from Monday. And then we will be sending them their gift. And, you know, the purpose of that is we know teachers take on, I mean, first of all, they are dealing with our children every day.
Yes.
They are amazing.
If there's one thing that the pandemic taught us too, is to never underestimate or underappreciate what a teacher does.
They are dealing with our children every day and molding them for the future. And but teachers have to take on so much on their own to set up their classrooms. And so we want to help make it just a little bit easier by giving them some support. And I will tell you, this has been a real collaboration. HWA Home Warranty, Eric Bacher from Bank Central, Phillips Floors, and Des Moines Area Roofing all pitched in to join us in this fourth annual teacher event this year. So nominate your favorite teachers. We love to honor them.
And, you know, when it comes to your sponsors, that's just another way that you have a partnership with some great people that can help make real estate easier as well, Misty.
Absolutely. I mean, we choose to work with partners that do a great job for our clients and really care about making sure that the people that we work with are taken care of. So we put a lot of thought into that.
And again, it's the fourth annual teacher giveaway. $3,500 worth of gift cards.
And I guess it must be back to school time if the Iowa State Fair is going on, huh?
I know. And have there been years, or is it just me remembering wrong, but the school had started during the fair for some students? I just feel like that should not happen. Maybe it did briefly.
Wasn't it a legal thing that they stopped it from happening?
Like, no kid should have to go to school while the fair is going
on. Well, it became a complication, actually, for districts that have year-round programs. And so that there had to be exceptions granted specifically around the state fair thing, I believe. Am I wrong about that?
I think so. Again, the state fair goes on through. It's a week from today. It ends on Sunday, August 21st. And Misty would like to have all of the nominees for this teacher giveaway in. And you're going to be announcing the winners next Monday, August 22nd.
Yes.
Text teacher to 35620. And also just look up Misty on the social media channels. I'm sure she has all the information
We've
there
as
well.
We've got things pointing in every direction to help you get your favorite teachers nominated. We have had such a huge response so far. Hundreds of teachers nominated. So get yours in there, too.
And I hate to fast forward ahead, but, you know, you always do things throughout the year. So what's next after the teacher giveaway? Would that be Thanksgiving pies or...
I think we actually are going to have another event prior to that related to, you know, I am with Better Homes and Gardens Real Estate, and it is the 100th anniversary of Better Homes and Gardens magazine. So we're going to do a special thing for that in October.
Well, there you go. A preview of more things, exciting things that Misty has on the way. So we're going to break a little early here today because coming up, we're going to have three of Misty's agents calling in with their state fair experiences, things they want to do. And one agent in particular that is actually, she has stayed, lived on the Iowa State Fair grounds.
Lived there, yes.
In a house. And I can't wait to find out. There's only a few what you would call homes on the fairgrounds.
We're going to get the scoop.
So we're going to get the scoop. That's on the way next on the Central Iowa Real Estate Scoreboard on 106.3 KXNO.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran. I built the number one brokerage firm in New York City by marketing luxury homes to the most qualified buyers. What makes the difference today in your area? The same thing, custom marketing to the right buyers. In Des Moines and Central Iowa, the agent I trust is Misty SOLDwisch. Her personalized marketing plan sells more homes for more money. If she can't find the right buyer on your deadline, she will buy it. Get the best marketing for your home. Go to soldincentraliowa.com and put more money in your pocket.
It's time to get Misty with it. And today, we're not so much checking out the Central Iowa real estate scene.
Well, I have just a little bit.
Just a little bit? Because we're going to also do state fair stuff, too.
It's more state fair related today. But I do have a quick stat. You know, we've been following how many homes have sold, you know, since we started the show back in 2020. And this past week, there were 375 new homes that hit the market, 358 that went under contract, and 386 closings. And it's really showing the changes that are happening. We'd seen week after week, there had been more homes that went under pending that came on the market. Mm-hmm. And that really started changing right around July 1st. And that number is growing. And that's great news for buyers. That means they have more options, that things aren't going like so crazy quick. It's really making the pace be a little more manageable for people. And so we're seeing people re-enter the market because of that.
Yeah, and we probably need to emphasize that this doesn't mean that it's a bad time to sell your home. It's just not going to be as frenetic.
You know, what that means is we've still retained the pricing increases. Yes, you don't have to like scramble so much. It's been great in both directions.
Right. All right. So real estate wise, tell me about the Iowa State Fairgrounds. How many acres?
I don't know, Heather. How many acres?
Sorry. I thought it's 445 acres. Out at the Iowa State Fairgrounds.
How much of it is that campground?
160 acres is the campgrounds. And I guess I knew this on some level, but the first state fair was held in Fairfield, Iowa, back in 1854.
But was it chosen because of the name Fairfield?
Yeah, I don't know. It seems like it would be a natural place to start it.
Yeah, let's start it in the town called Fairfield.
But you know what's funny, too? Like the first Iowa State Fair happened before the Great Western Expansion of the United States, even. That's how old the Iowa State Fair is.
Yeah, a grand tradition.
And the budget for the first fair, $323. When we head out to the fair, when we head out to the fair later today, I may just go ask the fair marketing director what the budget is for it now.
Right,
because I imagine it's just a little bit north of $323. Well, as promised, we've had some of Misty's agents call in, and I guess we can start taking them in the order that they called.
Yeah, let's do it.
Because Missy is on the phone. Good morning, Missy.
Good morning.
Missy Hatchett is a senior real estate specialist on my team.
Yes, that means that she can list homes, help buyers. Missy, what's going on with you today?
Well, I'm getting ready to head out to the fair. We have our team event out there kind of today. We're all going to go out and be there when you guys are on the radio later today. So looking forward to that, just trying to figure out which comfortable shoes I should wear. Probably not going to look very stylish, but probably going to go with the old faithful tennis shoes.
What form, you need to be comfortable to be walking around that fair though, right?
Absolutely, absolutely. And find the perfect shaded spot where I can, you know, have the advantageous spot of the best food options in a nice shady spot.
And you know what though? We've been outside today already and it is...
It's not like typical fair weather.
No, it's not. It's actually quite cool. We've picked a great day to go out to the fair today.
Yes.
Yay us.
So you mentioned something about food. What's on your radar?
I always like to go to the Turkey Federation and get a pulled turkey sandwich. I've been told like for breakfast, I may head over there because they have turkey sausage with a pancake wrapped around it with syrup for dipping. So that sounds super yummy. It'll just be, I rarely do I get there in time for breakfast. So today will be an adventure.
So Missy, what is your connection with the state fair in the past? Like, have you been a regular there?
Well, I was for a number of years when my daughter showed horses. She had a hackney pony that she would show at the society horse show there at the fair. People may not realize that the different horse breeds rotate in and out of the fair throughout the week. So it's not like all the horses are there at the same time. You have your draft breeds that come in and out, your quarter horses, and then there's the society breeds, which are the saddlebreds, Morgans, Hackneys, Frisians, that they're there for, usually it's the first Tuesday of the fair through Thursday. And so my daughter had her Hackney pony, and her first year out at the age of 10, she was the roadster to bike Hackney pony state champion.
Wow.
And yet another thing that I have in common with a team member, because I showed horses out there too, Missy.
There you go. Yeah. I was just the supportive mom on the rail. But no, my daughter was always fearless. Hackney ponies can be very high spirited, and the division she showed in, you showed at three gates, you showed at the jog, at the road gate, and then at speed. And you know, there was nothing more fun for a 10-year-old than to go mock two with her hair on fire, slinging the buggy around the corners and throwing dirt on me. She had a lot of success over the years, both riding and driving, and, you know, retired kind of when she hit high school, but I have hopes that maybe someday she'll take it back up again so that I can be the horse show mom again.
Oh, that's great. Did you, when you had your horses out at the fair, I'm remembering that I had the horse that I showed, and I was another 10-year-old running with her hair on fire. But I did barrel racing and pole bending and things like that. And the horse that I rode was super friendly, super nice. Like, we could turn him loose out in the pasture and out in the front yard, and he wouldn't run off. Sometimes he would even just lay down and take a nap in the front yard. That's how chill he was. But then, after a day and a half of people nonstop coming up and touching his face and petting him and stuff, he was, like, over it for a while. Mm.
Yes. Yeah. And hackneys can be kind of persnickety anyway. And it's always so funny to people who don't grow up around these things, and they're like, oh, it's a baby horse. It's like, no. It's a little bit different. But, I guess we were blessed. My grandparents lived on a farm. My parents now have a farm. So my kids, got to grow up around those things. So it wasn't quite such a culture shock when we went to the fair.
Well, Missy, thank you so much for checking in, and we'll see you out at the fair later today.
See you soon.
I'll see you guys later. Have a wonderful day.
Bye, Missy. That was Missy Hatchett, a senior real estate agent with Misty's team. Up next is Jamin. Good morning, Jamin.
Hi.
Jamin Hull is one of our newer agents with the team. He's a real estate associate, so excited to have you on. You shared that you are a longtime state fair enthusiast, is that right?
That's right. I was born and raised in New Mexico, and our state fair is nothing compared to Iowa.
Well, they say nothing compares to the Iowa State Fair. I think that's literally the fair slogan.
You know what?
So appropriate.
That's why, because they must have gone to the New Mexico State Fair and figured that out.
So when did you move to Iowa and start visiting the Iowa State Fair?
So my wife and I got married in 2000, and we moved here in 2001. And ever since, I've been going. We had a five-year gap there where we didn't go, and that's because we moved to California. So when we were in California, obviously, we weren't able to come to the fair, and every time that we come visit, it just wouldn't correspond with the fair time. So last year, we moved back, and I went to the fair.
So what are your favorite things to do there?
So my favorite thing is to eat, because the fair food is the best food. And if it's on a stick, I don't know why, but it makes it so much better.
Doesn't it?
It does. It's the weirdest thing. A pork chop on a stick. Who would have thought? But I love the corn dogs over there by the Pepsi clock. So last year, I was in line. And last year, I don't know if we went on the busiest day or what, but I was in line for a long time. I was in line for 10 minutes for my favorite corn dog. And it turns out I wasn't even in the corn dog line. I was in the fried pickle line.
Oh, no.
I know, right? And I was upset. But then I got my fried pickle, and now I have a new favorite fair food, and it's fried pickles. They're delicious.
I love the fried pickle. When they cut them up, like with the cream cheese and all of that. And
yeah.
The pickle dog.
The pickle dog. Those are so
good. Yeah,
yeah, that's one of my favorites, too.
Yeah, I love it.
What else is on your radar? Because they have some new fair foods, including a baked potato that looks like it could feed a family of four at the Rib Shack.
Yeah, I know, right? I don't know. I am pretty adventurous when I eat, but I don't want to like have to be carted out in an ambulance, you know what I mean, with all this cholesterol stuff going on. So I think I'll just stick to my corn dog, my pickle dog. I'll find some fried dessert. Oh, the taffy. I love the taffy over there. We get a big bucket of that every year.
Yeah. You don't want to do what I did, which was basically eat my way through the fair in a single afternoon. Yes, almost need to be carted out. I had state fair cookies.
Right.
I had a corn dog. I had strawberry shortcake in the ag building. And then I had the pickle bacon mac and cheese.
Well, you're a celebrity, though, Heather. They would give you a golf cart. Ugh, they wouldn't
it was bad.
You know, the ag building, speaking of the ag building, they have the best lemonade out there, right? Have you guys had that?
Yes.
Yeah.
Delicious.
You're right.
Oh, it is the best lemonade, the fresh squeezed right that they have right in the middle there.
Yeah.
So, Jamin, when you were living in California for 5 years, your hiatus from the Iowa State Fair, did you make it? Does California have a state fair? I imagine they do.
So they have, we went to the Ventura County Fair, which is a pretty big fair. But I don't know if they have a state fair, if they do, which I imagine they do. I don't know where it was. We went to the Malibu County Fair. We went to the Ventura County Fair. And the Malibu County Fair is pretty neat because you saw, like, a whole bunch of celebrities. Like, we saw Jimmy Fox. We saw a bunch of people over there, that one. And then the Ventura County Fair, not so many celebrities, but it was close. I mean, it wasn't close, but it was similar to the Iowa State Fair, just on a much smaller scale. But yeah, I don't know where the California State Fair would be held. We never did go to that one.
I don't either. But before we let you go, I know that you're a new agent on Misty's team here in Iowa. I have to ask before we let you go, but did you ever do real estate in California?
You know, no, I did not do real estate other than just buy and sell my house. I was like, this looks so fun. I wanted to buy it for myself.
All right, Jamin. Well, thank you so much for calling in, and we'll see you a little later today.
Yeah, thanks, Jamin.
All right, thanks.
And finally, we have Abby on the phone with us. Good morning, Abby.
Good morning.
Abby's been on the show before.
Yep.
Abby is a real estate specialist on the team, and she has some great past Iowa State Fair experience. What was it, Abby?
Yeah, definitely. So I was an intern with the Blue Ribbon Foundation at the Iowa State Fair. And if you're a fair lover, you really should know about the foundation because they raise all the money. They're the nonprofit that supports the fair. So any renovations that go on around the fairgrounds are supported by the Blue Ribbon Foundation. So I was in charge of all of the volunteers that came to the fair and worked water stands and merchandise stands. So that was a super fun summer that I was able to do that. And we actually stayed on the fairgrounds in the Earth home during the fair.
Wow, so it was the berm home. And actually, maybe it is an earth home because it's, I don't even know that the roof is grass, too.
It is. Yep, it's grass.
What was it like staying in there?
Well, that was our office throughout the summer. And then we kind of converted it to back to bedrooms during the fair. But it was so much fun because there was four interns, all college age. And we would just, you know, work all day and get done about 9 o'clock and then, you know, go have a little bit of fun on the fairgrounds, too.
I've got to ask, the Earth Home seems like it might be quiet, but you're staying in the middle of the fair, maybe trying to sleep in the middle of the fair.
Yeah. I mean, we pretty much worked and then hung out up until the fair was shut down, but it was pretty quiet. So we got, I think, some sleep throughout those 2 weeks.
So from that experience, are there any favorite things to do that you would have never known about had you not lived on the fairgrounds for a week?
That's a good question. I mean, I think I tried every single fair food and I got sick of it. That's for sure. I was like begging my parents to just bring me just regular food from home at that point. But one thing I would mention, so yesterday I went to the fair with my brother and his fiance, and she had never been. She's from the East Coast. And we went to the Animal Learning Center. So it's all the newborn baby animals. And I didn't think we were going to get her out of there. She was so excited and so happy to see all the little babies. There's lambs and chicks and piglets. So that's definitely a favorite spot and a good place to take people that have never been before. If you can't hit all the barns, you should definitely go to the Animal Learning Center and see
the
baby.
Well, who can resist a baby animal, right?
Right.
Yes.
So do you have any favorite fair foods now that you've had a little bit of time away?
And there's been so many new ones since then.
Now that you've had some time.
Yeah. So I actually kind of want to try that baked potato you were just talking about, but I would need a family of four to help me. I haven't tried that. I really like the G-Migs wrap, and I need to look up if it's there this year.
Well, I know G-Migs is there, so I'm assuming they have their wrap still.
What's
yeah.
special about the wrap?
They must have. Yeah, they might have moved to a new place. So I really like the Iowa wrap with pulled pork and corn. Corn in a cup. It's like Mexican corn in a cup. Really like that. And last night I had, you know, a classic corn dog because you just got to do it.
Of course you do.
I haven't heard anyone mention funnel cakes. Are those like, do people not like them anymore?
No, they're, I don't know. You know what? It's one of those foods that you just know it's going to be there and you'll probably have one at some point.
Yeah. I love funnel cake.
Yeah. That is crazy that nobody's mentioned funnel cake yet. And especially
corn dogs get all the glory.
Yeah. They've also had a couple of new twists on the corn or on the funnel cakes too, where you can like get red velvet funnel cake with the cream cheese drizzle. Oh, that's good too.
I like the classic. What other variations did they have though, Heather?
I want to say that I tried one that had, it was more like a breakfast one that was like drizzled with a little bit of butter and syrup. I don't know. They've got several out there.
So Abby was there when the fair squares were. Was that when they were debuting, Abby, when you were working there?
Oh, yes, the fair squares.
Do they still have those?
That's also a Blue Ribbon Foundation treat. They don't have the fair squares anymore.
So what were they exactly?
It was a Rice Krispie treat on a stick, and they were a great price. They were like $2.
And they were big.
A huge honka Rice Krispie treat. But I think the merchandise and the water sales is more what they're focused on now. And
right.
They were tasty, though.
Well, Abby, thank you so much for calling in. And we'll see you out there later today.
Sounds good. I'll see you in a little bit.
Thanks, right. Abby.
Thanks, Abby. Mm-hmm. Again, Misty and I will be broadcasting live on News Radio 1040 WHO from 1 to 2 o'clock this afternoon at the WHO Crystal Studios. In the meantime, it's time to check out the Home of the Week, Misty, because this is a great deal that you have going on.
I know, and it's been our Home of the Week before, but you know what? There's 15 homes out there, so we have a lot we can talk about.
Right.
So if you'd like to get a link to information on these homes, you just text KXNO to 35620. But we have a great new construction neighborhood not very far from the Iowa State Fairgrounds.
Exactly.
You can pop over there after you visited the State Fair today. It's the Woodbury neighborhood. National Home Corps has multiple homes, six of which have a $10,000 reduction in price for this month. I would call it maybe the State Fair special. But these are some great homes that are priced now between $305 and $355. And with six-year tax abatement, the first 3 years, 100% tax abated, if you're like, oh gosh, I would not be able to afford a home in the 300s, with that tax abatement, it's really like buying a resale home in the mid-200s, 250, like an entry-level home. So there's some really great opportunities for 3 to 4 bedroom ranches and 2 stories and in a Southeast Polk School District. But yeah, we will be open from 12 to 2 today. So no reason if you are on your way out to the fairgrounds not to pop on over.
Right. And it is just northeast of the fairgrounds, correct?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, it's close.
And that would not be a bad direction to come to the fair on a Sunday, too.
Exactly. It would be an advantageous route.
Yes, it would. So again, text KXNO to 35620 if you would like more information on that. And don't forget, you can text teacher to 35620 to nominate someone for the fourth annual teacher giveaway, too, with the Misty SOLDwisch home selling team. And again, Misty and I will be out at the fair today from 1 to 2 o'clock, WHO Crystal Studios on the Grand Concourse. And back next week, right here on 106.3 KXNO.